Hey there, Internet, how's it going? Nisa Koi, episode 3. I know that this really isn't necessarily like... I know that I'm a bit late with all these reviews, but hey, I like this anime and I want to review it. I'm only a few more episodes and I'll be hitting 9. So what happened this week in this crazy show? Or at least, like, what happened in episode 3, if I can remember? Episode 3 does honestly kind of start off with a bit of a flashback of Raku actually having a dream back when he first met the girl who gave him the little locket he wears, which honestly was a pretty nice little moment, which that after that it kind of cuts into the whole thing of him actually having to go to school and the whole school basically blowing up over the fact that Raku and Chitoge are now basically boyfriend and girlfriend, and that is a very, 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 very blown up scene of them just doing that. You know, it did honestly kind of get to the point in which that they were going man to basically like tell the truth about it. However, their clawed senses tingle, and they see this idiot just sitting up in a tree, just basically just staring them down and watching them, even though he knows 100% scent that they're not dating, because he's just stalking them at this point. Then pretty much it goes from that to like, or at least like most of this episode is honestly kind of veered around the idea of that they both pretty much kind of have a gigantic problem now, because he doesn't want Kosaki basically saying coming out and saying that this is his girlfriend, and or he doesn't want her to kind of misunderstand that, you know, he's basically trying man to tell her, and he can't because she doesn't want to listen to it. However, he does have a pretty good opportunity to kind of check out her key now, in which that at this point, this is the first time we actually kind of see her act like him, which is something that I do like of her just kind of just going all crazy and willy-nilly, because, man, you know, he does kind of see the key, and now she's running off and everything. And honestly, at this point, they both realize that they are the people who did kind of make the promise when they were kids. However, I still do kind of cling on to the fact that might not be the girl who he made the promise with all those years ago, possibly because in the opening there are two different keys, so there's also that. But going on from that, you know, he kind of does his thing, but then there's also another thing in this episode in which that Chitoge is really having trouble meeting having friends, or, you know, at the very least, she's having trouble talking to a lot of the other girls in school, because for one, she's not all that good at Japanese, and also she really isn't, just like Raku, she kind of has had a hard time making friends because of, you know, her being the daughter of a mob boss. Same thing with Raku, with him being the son of a Yakuza member, and most of his friends being chased away, and, you know, all this, and he has to work super hard. Wish that when he finds her, he finds that she's making like these little character notebooks about man the person, what they like and what they want to talk about and stuff like that. And basically Raku, he gives her a hand with it and all that. However, in the midst of that, it turns into a whole thing of them slowly blurting out that their relationship is a performance, and Kosaki hears it. However, she kind of really doesn't get the rest of what they were saying of that their relationship was a performance. So pretty much that's kind of how this episode goes off. It goes off with him actually kind of helping her make a few friends in school, and it does kind of have a very, very, very loving ending, or at least like, you know, a very nice ending and everything. But pretty much it was all fun and interesting as it ended. So that's kind of what I got to say about that. What do you guys think about it? Please tell me down there in the comment section. I'll see you guys on the next John Gray of the Show. I am out.